and welcome to another episode of FooBar. In today's episode, we are going to talk about the basics of DynamoDB. If you're interested in watching more content about serverless, cloud computing, or software engineer practices in general, subscribe to my channel in the red button below. I post a video every Tuesday. So let's get started. Happy New Year's! This is the first video of 2020. 2020 is here, and we are going to start this video talking about Dynamo. So this series that starts today is a full series of 4 videos on Dynamo and how to work with it. So in the first episode, that is this one, I will talk about the basics of Dynamo, so we are in the same page. In the second episode, we are going to start working on a real app. Well, a real app is not an app I have used at work, but it's some kind of app with some specifications and things that we want to do. We are going to design that app totally serverless, using functions, using SAM, using everything in AWS. And then we are going to model the data into a Dynamo table using all the different things that we are going to learn today. And in the last 2 episodes, we are going to code that. I will show you how I make that app work using JavaScript, SAM, and putting it up into the cloud. So that's the series. So in this episode, we are going to get started with the basic concepts. We are going to learn everything you need to know in order to move on. So now I will switch to my screen and show you some slides, and we will talk over on Dynamo. Dynamo is a hosted NoSQL database offered by AWS. I'm pretty sure if you have been watching my channel, you know a lot about Dynamo. But I want to start by the beginning a little bit, so we can move from there to a little bit more harder concepts. Dynamo is called a database service as it's totally managed by AWS. That means that you don't need to install it and operate it and scale it up, you just use it. That's one of the magic things of Dynamo and why I love. Dynamo is a document or key value NoSQL database, and it scales very, very well to massive numbers, and it also scales down almost to zero, so you can use it for very small projects or for amazingly big projects. One of my favorite things from Dynamo is the access control. You can define very fine-grained permissions to the table. You can create roles that only allows you to read or put elements into the table and not delete or even read the elements in the table. So it's very, very powerful, the access control. And then DynamoDB has amazing features. We are not going to cover a lot of the strange features or very specific features of Dynamo, but I would like to make more videos on Dynamo. So if there is other features that you would like to see, let me know in the comments and I'm happy to tackle them. One of the features that I love and I have created videos of is DynamoDB streams, and I leave you the links in the description box for those videos so if you want to learn more about DynamoDB streams and what they are. So let's start by the basic concept of Dynamo and most of any database, that is a table. And basically a table in Dynamo is like a catalog in a relational database. You can put many items into a table, and the items in the table doesn't need to have the same attributes at all. That's one of the most important things that you need to know when working with Dynamo, that you can mix up the items in the table. You can have students, facilities, and courses all in the same table with no problem. An item is a group of attributes that is uniquely identifiable among other items. So it's important that when you create a table, you need to give the table name, and then you need to tell Dynamo what is the primary key of the table. The primary key in a table is something that uniquely identifies each of the items. And there is 2 types of keys in Dynamo. The partition key, and then the partition key plus sort key. So the partition key by itself is basically a simple primary key, only one attribute, and that's what Dynamo used to find the items. Every item should have a different partition key. So basically, Dynamo will produce a hash operation into this partition key, and then with that hash, it will find the item and where it's stored and retrieve it to you. The second option is the partition key and the sort key, and this is a composite primary key and is composed of two attributes. The first attribute is the partition key and the second attribute is the sort key. Dynamo uses the partition key as, again, the input to the hash function, and then the output of the hash function determines the partition, the place where this item is stored, and then all the items with the same partition key are stored together and they are sorted by the sort key. So I will show you more on how keys are stored and managed in Dynamo in a moment. In a table that has a partition key and a sort key, it is possible for these two items to have the same partition key value. However, those two items might have different sort key values, so the item is identifiable. So every time you insert into DynamoDB, you must at least have a partition key attribute. And it can also have a sort key. That's optional. When you do this, it gives you the opportunity to make quite complex queries against the items with the sort key. You can think of the partition key as a folder or a bucket that contains items, and the sort key orders the items in that folder. That's kind of an easy way to see how the partition key works. And then you can use the sort key to do queries with range operators like equals, bigger, smaller, less than, begins with, contains in, and things like that. You want to model your table to support one of the main access patterns. And you want the table that is able to query something that is relevant to your application. So don't just put any partition key just because it looks useful. Think about it, and we will talk about more on this and how to model your data in the next video, when I will show you some tips and tricks on how to decide which is a good partition key and which one is a good sort key. And remember that you can only have one item with a particular combination of partition key and sort key. So let's go into the partition keys into more detail. And let's look on how Dynamo stores physically the items in the system. Partition keys are used to identify the items, but they are also used to distribute the items across the key space. When you're storing items in Dynamo, you need to distribute those items in the key space. So then not all the items are in the same partition, so you can make the fetch of the items more efficiently. So what Dynamo does, it will hash the partition key and then use that hash and order the items according to the partition key, depending on what is the hash. This is how most NoSQL databases work, and then Dynamo will split this partition key space into different pieces, and that will be the different partitions that this database will have. And this depends on how big your database is. If you have a very big database, you will have a lot of partitions. If you have a smaller database, you will have smaller ones. So now when you query the database, you will give the partition key and the database will know in which kind of physical node to look for the data. And this is what makes NoSQL databases very fast at retrieving data. So when you include the sort key, now the process is very similar. Dynamo will use the partition key to fetch the item from the right partition. And in that partition, there will be many items with the same partition key, as these items are using a composite key. And then they will be sorted by the sort key, so you can find now the particular item inside the partition. This is also quite normal in all NoSQL databases. In Dynamo, partitions are replicated in a free way. So when you write to Dynamo, you will get an acknowledgement from the database that at least two of the replicas have received the write operations. When you read from Dynamo, you have the choice to have an eventual consistency read or a strong consistency read. The one that comes by default is the eventual consistency read. That means that you are reading from any of the replicas, so data might have not been replicated yet. But this is not quite common unless you're reading extremely fast. In general, Dynamo is quite consistent on how it's replicating its data. But if you want to be 100% sure that you're getting a strong consistency, you can use the operation to do a strong read. But Have in mind that doing a strong, consistent read is extremely expensive. It's double the price of a normal read. Now, let's talk about secondary indexes. In Dynamo, secondary indexes are super important, and this is a very important concept when you're using Dynamo. You can create one or more secondary indexes on a table. A secondary index lets you query data in the table using an alternate key in addition to queries against the primary key. DynamoDB doesn't require that you use indexes, but this gives the application quite a lot of flexibility when you're querying data. After you create a secondary index on a table, you can read data from the index in the same way that you do it from the table. This is super important to understand that finding things in Dynamo is extremely easy if you know the partition key and the sort key, or just the partition key, and then you apply some operations on the items that are retrieved. But finding things that you don't know the key is extremely hard. Scanning the databases or doing just select like search operations without any idea on the keys is extremely expensive and hard. So that's why secondary indexes are super, super important, because they help you to create different keys into your data so you can find items in different ways. We will take a lot of usage in our example when we are building our application using these indexes. These are a core part of Dynamo, and you need to understand how important these are. There are two kinds of secondary indexes in DynamoDB: the global secondary index, that is an index with a partition key and a sort key that can be different from the ones in the table, and a local secondary index, that is an index that has the same partition key as the table but a different sort key. Each table in DynamoDB has a limit of 20 global secondary indexes, is a limit by default, and 5 local secondary index by table. Using indexes is a great way to provide flexibility. So let's look now in more detail on the local secondary indexes. These indexes allows you to resort the data in the partition. So for example, we have a table that my partition key is the customer ID and the sort key is the date of the orders, but then I want to get all the orders in a particular state for a particular customer. So what I can do is I can create a local secondary index with that partition key to be the same as the customer ID and the new sort key to be the status order. And I just can query all the orders that are shipped or all the orders that are in progress from a particular customer. The partition key always is the same as the table partition key, and this is just to sort the data inside the partition, not all the data. When you create a local secondary index, you need to specify which of the attributes of the table will be projected into the index. When you project attributes, that means that you get those items from in the index, and you can query and do things on them. There are 3 options to work with the to project the items into the index. The first one is the key only. It will only project to the index the keys, the partition key, there's only one, and the old sort key and the new sort key. Then include A3 in this case. It will project all index keys as the option below before, and also project attributes that you specify. And then it will project all the attributes into the index. Then we have global secondary indexes. In this case, we are resorting all the data in the table in a global secondary index. These indexes allows you to create new different ways to aggregate the data. So we have a table that has the customer number and the order date, and then the partition key and the sort key. And then we create a global secondary index that is by order number and the order status. Same data, but it's just resorted. And using these indexes, we can support secondary access patterns by regrouping and resorting the existing data. And again, when you specify your global secondary index, you need to tell which attributes you will be projecting into the indexes. And there are the same options. You can project the keys only, and in this case, you will get the old and the new partition key and the old and the new sort key. And then you can include particular attributes that you want as well as the keys, or then you can project all the different attributes. And finally, one last thing I want to say about indexes, that global secondary indexes are eventual consistencies and local secondary indexes are strongly consistent. When you make an update to a global secondary index, you will get an acknowledgement that the process has started, and then the synchronous process of updating all the global secondary indexes will start. So it takes a little time, so be just aware of that. This was the video for today. I hope you like it. If you did, give a big thumbs up. And remember, next week there is another video on this series, and we are going to get started working on the data modeling for the data into Dynamo. And that is another theoretical video, but it's very, very important that it will help you to understand on how to code it, because the code part is the simple part if you know how to model the data. Around here, there are videos from my channel for you to watch, so go ahead and click. And if not, I see you next week with another episode on FooBar. Ciao, ciao!